Join us in the Canadian Rockies of Alberta and experience one of the most stunning destinations in the world. We visit the town of Jasper and many beautiful sites in the area. Jasper National Park is the largest park in the Canadian Rockies. The town of Jasper is 365 kilometers west of Edmonton. It is also 413 kilometers northwest of Calgary, on a route which takes you through Banff National Park and up through the Icefields Parkway, one of the world's most scenic highways. I will do a separate video of sites along the Icefields Parkway. Of the 11 sites we see, the furthest away is 48 kilometers from Jasper, with quite a few being very close to town. Some locations have their own video with more information, which you can enjoy via a link in the description below. The town of Jasper has a year-round population of about 5,000 people, with an additional 12,000 seasonal workers. Jasper gets about 40% fewer visitors than Banff, so being less busy and touristy than Banff, Jasper has a more laid-back, small-town feel which we enjoy. Close to town, we stumbled across Old Fort Point Road. Across the river is a parking lot with access to walking trails. The bridge has a walkway with beautiful views of the Athabasca River. A set of stairs leads up to the rock face with a wonderful panoramic view. An old Fort Point Trail also starts here with a 3.7 kilometer hike ending with this view. Nearby is Lake Beauvais with a 3.4 kilometer trail around its perimeter and a golf course on its east side. Across the lake, we see Jasper Park Lodge. There is a boathouse near the lodge where you could rent paddle boats, canoes, kayaks, paddle boards, and bikes. This is one of a series of small lakes close to Jasper on the east side of the river. Further north is Annette Lake, a favorite of mine. It has a large parking lot on the northeast end of the lake, along with the beach. And it has an enjoyable walking trail, 2.7 kilometers around the lake, even more beautiful if you catch it on a sunny day. Just north of town on the east side of the river is Maligne Lake Road, with three sites worth visiting. At the end of the road, 48 kilometers from Jasper, sits Maligne Lake. It is the largest natural lake in the Canadian Rockies, resting in a valley of snow-capped mountains. This is the original boathouse, built in 1928, where you can rent canoes and kayaks. A popular activity here is the cruise to Spirit Island, one of the most photographed spots in the Canadian Rockies. You can watch my video on the history of Maligne Lake, which includes the cruise to the island. About midway along the Maligne Lake Road is Medicine Lake. It fills up in the summer from a large volume of glacial meltwater flowing down from Maligne Lake, 15 kilometers away. I catch it here with a fair amount of water flow. What is unique about Medicine Lake is that it disappears. The bottom of the lake has sinkholes, and the water slowly drains down into a massive underground cave system. In the fall, very little water flows into the lake, so by November it looks more like a mudflat. An experiment was conducted placing non-toxic dye into the lake, and the dye appeared in Maligne Canyon, 15 kilometers away, which we see next, and also down in the Athabasca Valley, including Lakes Beauvert, Annette, and Lake Eda. The Maligne Canyon is an absolute must-see when visiting Jasper. Only 11 kilometers from town, it is the first major site you come to when driving the Maligne Lake Road. It has spectacular views with hiking trails and four bridges along the canyon. The effects of the underground cave system is seen here too. The Maligne River is fairly small, entering the canyon. Then additional water flows into the canyon from the underground cave system. So as the river drops through the gorge, several larger underground streams rejoin, amplifying the amount of water flow. We see it here during its highest water flow in 40 years. So by the time the Maligne River exits the canyon, it's 10 times larger than when it entered. There are two other parking lots further out at bridges 5 and 6, which are part of the larger hiking trail. You can watch my complete video on Maligne Canyon. If you are adventurous, you can book an ice walk tour in the winter. A short drive northwest of Jasper are a couple lakes. Patricia Lake does not have much for public access unless you're staying at Patricia Lake bungalows or bring your own equipment. Further up is Pyramid Lake, and it's a short 10-minute drive from Jasper. Along the south end of the lake are a handful of small parking areas with picnic tables and a beach at the end of the road. At the southeast end of the lake is Pyramid Lake Resort, where you can rent paddle boats, rowboats, canoes, kayaks, and bikes. Further up the lake, we come to Pyramid Island. This is a beautiful spot for a pleasant walk around the small island. It includes bench seating for 50 people and can be reserved for weddings. A short 8 kilometers south of town is the Jasper SkyTram. It has great vistas of the valley and town site below. At the top is a trail continuing further up the mountain featuring 360-degree views. Warmer clothing may be required, as the temperatures up top are about 12 degrees Celsius colder than in town. This footage was from the end of September 2020. On August 10th of the same year, we were very surprised one morning to awaken to a snow-covered mountaintop. You may want to catch my video on the Jasper SkyTram as well. Continuing south past Marmot Basin Ski Resort, we eventually reach the turnoff to Mount Edith Cabal. Following a very windy road, we reach a parking lot. Mount Edith Cabal is named for a British nurse, even though she never visited Canada. During World War I, she was executed by Germans for helping Allied soldiers escape. We follow the path of the glacier trail to a vantage point where we see the Angel Glacier on the mountain and Cabal Pond below. Unfortunately, the glacier is eroding rapidly and is likely to eventually disappear. Cabal Pond is rimmed with ice along the base of the mountain. We were here about 35 years ago, so we noticed the area had been renovated. In 2012, about 60% of a smaller ghost glacier fell from the mountain. It was hanging on a ridge left of the Angel Glacier. About 125 cubic meters of ice, 20 meters thick, crashed down, launching ice blocks 4.5 meters thick to land further away. It blasted away the warning signs near the shoreline. It showered the picnic area with rocks and gravel. And a huge downflow flooded the parking lot with 1.5 meters of mud, wrecking the pavement. Fortunately, it happened during the night when no one was around. To be safe, visitors are recommended to stay on the trail and not get too close to the pond. There is also a longer Cabell Meadows Trail for a 6-kilometer round-trip hike for even better views of Angel Glacier and Cabell Pond. Further south is Athabasca Falls, 32 kilometers from Jasper. It is a thundering waterfall with a walking trail and bridges overlooking the gorge. Following the path will eventually lead down to a wonderful view of the river exiting the gorge. To see more, watch my complete video on the Athabasca Falls. I will quickly mention two more destinations. Another 24 kilometers south is Sunwapta Falls, placing it 56 kilometers from Jasper. It has a bridge and a trail on both sides of the river. I'll showcase this one on my Icefields Parkway video. And 60 kilometers northeast of Jasper is Mayette Hot Springs, open mid-May to mid-October. Unfortunately, it was closed during COVID, so I have no videos or pictures of my own to share. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.